Hello everyone. In this video, I'll show how to create the sample form design by using FlatLaf. We can filter the employee by name or by positions. We can create new employee. When we save, the data store in the database and load new in this table. And we can edit the employee. And we can select row to delete or select all row by using checkbox custom. So for database we using MySQL for store data, and now let's start. Here the library that we will use in this project. This for FlatLaf, so we have FlatLaf extras, FlatLaf font and JSVG. And this for JDBC library, for work with database, so we use DBCP, Commons Pool and MySQL Connector version 8. And this for MIG layout. And we use DateTime Picker, GlassPane Pop-up and Toast Notification. So here project that I have created NetBeans, and I have add all the library into this project. And I have create JFrame form here, so in main method, we have installed the Roboto font library, then set this font for default font, and set up the FlatLaf look and feel, for theme we use Mac Lite. So we run this, here we get the empty frame. Now create new JPanel. Then we go to apply FlatLaf style to this panel, by create init method here. To create style the panel we use method put client property. And we use style properties. Arc to create the round border so we set 25. And for background we set as the table background. So next we going to create the JTable. Move the JTable drop into the JPanel, and make the table width fill of JPanel width. And we double click here to set the gap, so we set as 20. For bottom gap we set 10. Then select on this table, and check here to enable this table auto resize width and height. And for this panel we also enable resize width and height. Here we can see the table and panel, now auto resize when we maximum the frame. And in navigator here, we need change the variable name for scroll pane and table. And for table scroll pane we no need the border, so we can set it to empty border. And for this table we need change the column title. For the first column we set editable true, and for type change to boolean type. And we set the size to the column. Then at the top here we need create the separator line. And we need create style for this table header. Go to init method here. We need get table header from JTable, and use FlatLaf style client properties. This for header height we set 30. We no need hover background so we set to null. And also pressed background, set to null. For For separator color, we set as the table header background. And then font we use bold. So next we going to create the table style. We set the table row height to 30. Enable the horizontal line. But when we select rows, we can't see the horizontal line. So we need use intercell spacing. 0 for vertical, 1 for horizontal. But we see the black border in focus cell here, so we can remove it. By set the cell focus color as the table header hover background, because we use the table row selection color as the header hover background. So here we can't see the focus border color, because it's the same color with the selection color. But we need go to enable the editable row, for input some text for test. Here we can see the selection foreground as white color, so we need change it to default foreground. And we go to add more row for test. So we see the table scroll bar here. Now we go to style this scroll bar. To style this scroll bar, we need use method get the vertical scroll bar from the scroll pane. Here the track arc, we set 999 for full round border. Track insets set all 3. And thumb insets all 3. And for background we set as the table background. So next we going to custom the table header as the checkbox. We need new package. Then create new class as checkbox table header renderer. Extends this class from jcheckbox. And implements from table cell renderer. So here we need override method get table cell renderer component. In this method we return this object, so it will render the checkbox component. Then we need create jtable object here. And this for column index, for specific column that we want to apply. Create constructor to init both value. So now go to main form and apply this cell custom to the table. But here we need to center the checkbox and set the background style. Create init method. Use client properties to style the checkbox background. For background we set as table background. And set horizontal alignment to center. Here, but we need the header line color. For create the line to this checkbox, we need draw by using graphics 2D, so we can override method paint component here. set the line color. For color, we use table header bottom separator color. This is color from the FlatLaf style properties. Then create the line size. We use scale because the FlatLaf have option to scale the UI, so we want the line size or auto scale to the FlatLaf. And then fill the line by using rectangle 2D. Here now we have the checkbox header, but we cannot click it, so now we need create the mouse event click to the table header. By add mouse listener to table header here. We use mouse pressed event, so override the method mouse pressed here. Check the left mouse button. Then get the pressed column index. In table we have method column at point, to get the column index by mouse location. And then if the column that we pressed equal to column that we set, so we going to change the checkbox selection. Now we can change the selection the checkbox, so next we going to select and unselect table row. Create new method as selected table row. Then loop to all row of table. Set the selected value to the table. And then call this method in mouse pressed event. Here now we get the selected and unselected row. But when we have some row selected and some row unselected like this, we show the checkbox as indeterminate. So first we need add event value change to table model, by get model from the table, and call event add table model listener. And here we check if the value has changed at column that we set. Create new method to check row. And then call this method in this event, so the method check row will work when value changed. So to set the checkbox to indeterminate, we use FlatLaf style properties. And this to remove the selected state properties. And we also remove the indeterminate when we press the checkbox. Then we need to remove the table row that contain the null value. And we go to create sample data here for test. Here I have generate data. Here now it work. But for table header we do not allow to user move the column like this. We can disable it by go to table contents customize. Uncheck this option. Now we cannot move the column header. So next we going to create cell alignment. By create new class as table header alignment. and implements from table cell renderer. Then create table cell renderer object for old header renderer. And this for old table row cell renderer. Here we can get the header cell renderer for this table. Then override method getTableCellRenderer component. We need get the component from old header renderer. Return this label. And here create method to get alignment. So if the column at index 1, we return the center. Then set this alignment to this J label. I1 is the column, so we can change it. And this for row. Now go to main form and apply this to the table. Here now we can alignment the header, but not for row, so we need apply this alignment to table row. For this we use old cell renderer, not old header renderer. And here use the same with header. And thank you everyone for watching. See you next video.